Yeah, lovely.
Oh, I've just been out with Jack sorting his bedrooms out. He's got his mother-in-law moving in.
Oh, don't talk to me about mother-in-laws. Honestly, every time I think my one's getting better, she bubbles over again. I'm starting to think I'm never going to see my L again.
Cheers,
I'll tell you what, I'll treat you to that, son.
Cheers.
Nothing has been in the planning stages.
I'm talking about you, so you're planning stuff without telling us.
But if it does go ahead, it might not be a bad idea.
Of course it will.
Where are they moving us to?
Look, they don't know if the move's going ahead yet. It's all tied in with the proposed rail links.
Yes, it is.
All I do know is they are looking at the old flower market on Chichester Street. The idea is a covered market.
Yeah, exactly, and they're going to triple our pitch fees.
Well, the stalls will be bigger and you'll have better facilities.
Yeah, but I can barely afford to pay the pitch fees to Ian here.
So that guy in the suit?
Yeah, one of my council contacts.
Oh, of course
he wanted to talk me through the layout.
Yeah.
Look, I get that you're anxious, but I do think that you are overreacting and nothing is set in stone.
Whose side are you on, Carmel? Ours or the council?
Yeah, or your own, yeah? This little council contact of yours, what's he bunging you a few quid, is he?
The first I heard about this was this morning. Look, you know how much this market means to me. The fact that they are talking about moving it shows how much they're invested in it. It is a thriving market.
Okay, well, let's see what it's like then when it's not thriving. Because I say we go on strike.
What's the point of that? You're self-employed.
But we've got to show the council that we're not prepared just to be moved. Who's with me?
I can't afford to not work.
Come on, I think you're overreacting a little bit.
All because I'm not prepared to just sit here, eh? Fine, you lot just stay in, you stick your heads in the sand. I ain't.